Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Sorry about the light up there. I was having a little complication with my actual stand where I stick my phone. Today is going to be a makeup haul. I'm going to try to be as in-depth as possible. There, that works out better so the light's not like zoom. Sorry guys, again, my setup's not great. I'll work on it. Today I wanted to start off with the monthly Morphe subscription, the brush subscription. You do get anywhere from 3 to 6 full-size brushes every month for $19.99. You can always skip a month if you don't like the Morphe brushes. You can also stop at any time if you do not wish to continue to get them. Just keep in mind that if you do that, there's always usually a waiting list to get back on, so I wouldn't recommend that. So anyways, long story short, this month's brushes are these brushes. Now let's start off with this brush right here. Now this brush is the E46 mini angled buffer brush. Now, I don't typically open all my brushes because I have a lot of brushes, you guys. So, I'm mainly building all my brushes. Honestly, I don't know if I'll ever stop this unless I absolutely have to. But, hey, you get some pretty cool brushes. Now, this little E46 mini angled buffer brush, it says you may have a few bags under your eyes after St. Patty's Day, but this brush has got you covered. Grab your fave concealer and use this mini angled buffer to cover up the hangover. So I was already thinking like, this is too big for your face, like for your face, for your eyes. But apparently it's for under your eyes and it's to buff out concealer. So thank God they send these little like cards with it. Now also the next one is an E56 deluxe under eye powder brush. The soft dense brush will bring you tons of luck when beating your face. It's dom tailed allowed. Dude, I cannot talk today. I don't know what the hell's wrong with me. Sorry. This soft dense brush will bring you tons of luck when you're beating your face. It's domed head hollowed so you can set your under eyes flawlessly but buff and blind your worries away. Wouldn't that be nice to just blend my worries away? Like, nice one, Morphe. But hey, it will blend away, I guess, whatever else you need to blend away on your face. The next one is an E24 bullet crease. This brush may be short and sneaky like a leprechaun, but it won't steal your bling. Use it to add your pop of shimmer in your inner corner and define those shining eyes. So this is the brush. I have more than one of these brushes, so chances are I won't open this brush. Sorry about the light. Keeps kind of like popping in and out. Now this, you can spritz it with any setting spray. You can spit it with, as Candy Lover says, your what does she call it, it's her Baba Mahiga, which is her spit. I would recommend doing that. If you have a setting spray, use it. If not, you can use a little bit of water. But anyways, for the inner corner, again, anywhere from 3 to 6 brushes, $19.99. I will put my link below if you're interested in subscribing. Hopefully there's no wait. Next thing I'm going to talk about are my Live Glam, which is through Morphe too, lippy subscriptions. Now you get 3 of the lippies for $19.99. Also, there's some crazy colors that come with these, I'm going to tell you that. And there's colors that are beautiful. Now I have a bunch of these and I really can't part with these. Rather, it's probably even that color I probably will never use, but I'm still going to use it somehow, some way. I will incorporate it in my eyes, rather my lips, because you can use matte lipsticks for eyeshadow. Now this month, again, these are $19.99. you can skip a month. You can like, if you don't like the colors, you can skip the month. I typically don't, because the more the merrier, right? Also, They're $19.99 if I haven't already said that. And again, you can skip the month if you don't want the colors. You can stop your subscription at any time. So these months are going to be, forgive me guys, I'm a little blind. This is called Glam Rock. It's a red color. I can swatch them for you. I don't know how good the swatches are going to be, but here you go. So that's the color of that one. It's more like a gloss, like a red gloss, although I've never seen a red gloss. Well, maybe you have, but I haven't. The next one is going to be Lucky Charm. Maybe you'll get lucky when you wear this. And then this one, I'm going to swatch it right next to the other one. That's a very pretty, like a pinkish nude color. Sorry, I have my window open. And then this crazy color right here, of course, they had to go with green because it is St. Patty's Day. So it's called Leprechaun. And let me go ahead and swatch that for you right now. We'll do it right here. So anyways, this is a really cool color. I'm telling you, I wouldn't use it on my lips, but I would definitely use it like as an eyeshadow and buff it out. So anyways, these three brushes are, these three lippies are the March lippies for my Glam. Again, $19.99. I'll link the link down below if you're interested and subscribing. Now, let's get into the real deal. Now, I don't know. Most likely, you guys have heard of this. If not, then welcome to my channel. You're about to hear it. So, I've been seeing this little muddy mask go around, and I decided I wanted to get it. Have I tried it? No. But I heard it works wonders with people that have, like, acne scars, and it's really good for your face. And I have really bad acne scars on my face. So, according to this, it says, are you ready to hashtag get muddy? Want to get muddy? Duh. Here's how to make the project the perfect mask. Start off with a small bowl, mix a spoonful of powder, and gradually add a few drops of water. The consistency of your mask based on preference. Thick paste, light consistency, less water. Then liquid, light consistently, from add more water. So basically, I can't read for shit right now. I'm like stuttering. The point of it is if you want a thick one, you're going to use a few drops of water. If you want a thin one, you're going to use more water. Let's see what the benefits are. It says it's a multi-masking, using multiple masks at one time to target all problems areas. Example, use your detox mask to treat your T-zones, refresh mask to target your oily areas, and relax mask around your cheeks to even out your skin tone. So the money mask, which is this one right here, let me show you. There's more than one. I got the detox clay mask, so it's just telling you about all their masks. And I'm not really gonna get into it. It says use 2 to 6 days, every 2 to 6 days, depending on your skin type. For sensitive dry skin, it's best to start with one mask every 4 to 6 days. My case. For normal to combination skin, you can use a mask every 2 to 3 days. And again, there you go, hashtag get muddy with me. Well, not me, with them. Gosh, I can't talk today. Sorry guys, I'm like dragging on this haul and I'm stuttering. I'm like really tired today. Next, I went to Ulta and I decided to go a little bit shopping because I needed some stuff, and some stuff I wanted to grab to review because it's just been trending and I just haven't had the chance to go and buy it. This is not new. This, I'm sure you guys heard about. If you haven't, it is amazing. It helps with your pores on your face. And it's called the Pore Professional Pore Primer by benefit. It's a smoothing face primer to minimize the look of pores. So it does. I've used it before. I have huge pores, and let me tell you, this helps. It's pricey. This is the mini one. It was only $13 at Ulta, so if you want it, go and get it. Next, I'm gonna tell you about this because I heard about it, so I decided to buy it, but I haven't tried it. And it's because I'm almost out of my other one, but I went and bought me one either way. And this is the Kiss Strip Lash Adhesive Latex. Says it has aloe in it. It's the number one selling glue. Yeah, I don't know. People do talk about it, though. Never tried it. This was, I think, $6 at Walgreens, and they didn't have my usual duo. Now, the duo one, I like it just because it is basically a safe one to use. It says it's a brush-on strip lash adhesive. It's free. What does it say? Latex and formula hide free sands. I don't fucking know, guys. I'm cursing. I'm trying to figure out. There's a benefit to this. It has A, C, and E vitamin on it. And I want to say it's animal cruelty free too, but I'm not 100% sure. But anyways, I use it. I like it. It's my favorite, and it does last long. And this is it. It's duo. So that is that. This makeup haul is going great, right? You're doing great, sweetie. Next. Oh, wait. This brush came with this mask. They didn't come together. Apparently, you gotta buy your own little thing. And this thing was kind of pricey just because it has this gold stuff on it. My bougie ass still bought it. It was like either $6 or $9. And I think the other cheaper version was like $3. And the mask itself was, I think, like $35 or $39. Now, next, we have this e.l.f. foundation that I don't know how new it is, but I've seen people use it, and I just wanted to try it out. So, this is something I bought as well, and I'll be trying this out. Then, I also decided, why not, and I was in the e.l.f. section to buy two products that a lot of people are raving about, and I just wanted to try them. And they are the new 16 hour camel concealer e.l.f. brand concealers, obviously. And I got the shade medium sand and fair warm. Now, fair warm is clearly too light for me, but I got it to prime my eyelids. That's fair warm. And then this is medium sand, and I got it to conceal with. So each of these little babies were $6 each. And I decided to pick them up because why not? I also got another concealer while I was... Two more concealers while I was at it. That light is really bothering me. And one of them is the L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer to match my favorite concealer. Although when I swatched this one, it looked really pretty, and then it had like a pink undertone, so I don't know how this is going to work out, but coverage wise, it's really good. Then lastly, the last concealer I bought was the ColourPop No Filter Concealer, because I mean, a lot of people talk about this concealer and it works really good according to them, so I wanted to try it. So your girl bought about four concealers. Because I be trying to cover up all my imperfections under here, you know. So, the more the merrier. Oh, and then I bought this Clinique. Oh, you guys, Clinique is really good. I know it's good because my friend uses Clinique foundation. Everything in, like, her skin looks amazing. Now, this is a Clinique Moisture Surge 72-Hour Auto Replenishing Hydrator, and it says it's auto rehydration formula. So This hopefully works for my dry ass skin, because your girl has some dry skin, so we'll see how that works out. And lastly, as if I don't already have enough setting sprays, I just had to try this one because everybody raves about it. They had another one that's supposed to control oil, and I'm combo, like my skin's oily to dry. And this is supposed to be a setting spray that's used to make your makeup stay on and last all night. Now, coming from someone who's tried many, many setting primers, aside from Morphe, me loving it, it doesn't make your makeup last long. The MAC Fix Plus is one of my favorite to hydrate my face, but it also doesn't make your makeup last all night long. I've tried the MAC Fix Plus, MAC Fix Plus, the FX, Cover FX, the Mario Badescu, whatever. I've tried a couple different ones, and I get some in my boxy and I try them too, but let's just tell you, to tell you the truth, none of them have ever helped my makeup last all day. So I heard this one does. We'll have to see what happens. Now, enough with store. That was like, some of them were drugstore products, some of them were Morphe products, some of them were a little high end. I think actually the only high end one I got was the Urban Decay, this one, setting spray, and then this one. Now, moving along, kiddos, or friends, I should say, let's get to the best part. Why are we here? We're here mainly for the Morphe, right? Now, I had pre-recorded this because I was going to add it to my Morphe review, and I went to Ulta, and I'm kind of mad at myself because I haven't done it, because I was actually thinking about going and getting the primer and setting powder for it, and I forgot. Now, let's start off with Mr. Morphe / Jeffree Star collab brushes. I was so excited about these brushes, you guys, and I still am, but I would have to say that this bag, for all the hype Jeffree Star did on it, I could go find this bag somewhere in these colors without the name to me. Now, the brushes are here, and they feel kind of cheap even though they look super fancy, but I guess we'll have to try them out and see what they're all about. And you guys, don't at me because I said that. I'm just giving my opinion. Like, seriously, this bag right here was unnecessary. But I guess we could be happy he added it, right? I mean, because he didn't have to, but he did. But it's not anything special. Anyways, I can't even close the motherfucker. Next, we have his famous little brushes. Dun, dun, dun. These were $16. The brushes were $49. Still haven't tried any of them. Still waiting to try them. And then setting spray. I have more than one of these, but you can never have too many. Then we also have the foundation. Mine is an F2110. I just couldn't match myself last time on the website, so I had to go in the store, and to be honest with you, even though they have like a lot of colors, when I say a lot, they have a lot, it's almost like they were a tad off on every color. It's almost like they made a variety of colors for people, but they just missed it by a little bit, because this one probably is not even gonna match me 100%, but it was the closest to it. And I went based off of the colors that they say to go off of to maybe match yourself. Not true. Next, we have the concealer, which I have tried, and it's amazing. And it's the C165 Soft Matte Concealer. I do love this concealer, guys. Don't get me wrong. And then this little spoolie came with the pomade the brow pencil, which I have tried already, and it's garbage. It doesn't have very much pigment. I like that they gave you this. For those who don't have one, you got one. And it actually comes with this, and the pomade. And it comes with this little, the whole kit comes with this little highlighting thing as well. It's a highlighting thing for like under your brow thing. It's pretty creamy. I tried it already. Brow gel. I'm not the best fan of that. Like, I think Anastasia is better. And then lastly, we have the pomade, which is in hazelnut, and I have not tried it, but I did like swatch it, and it was pretty good. It was pretty pigmented. It smells right. Let's just hope it don't dry up like any other typical pomade. But with that being said, that concludes my makeup haul. And yeah, I'm done with this. I hope you guys like it. I hope you guys enjoy it. Don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to your girl's channel, because, you know, I'm going to be doing a review on all this stuff. And hopefully you guys like this. If you guys want more makeup haul review thingies, well, they're not review. They was kind of a review. Anyways, if you guys want more makeup hauls, let me know. I did buy most of the stuff. A good 85 to 90% of it just came out. So let me know if you want more of those, okay? Bye.